Hello everyone, how are you? I want to tell you my number one tip to keep feeling motivated about drawing and to love your art all the time. And the answer is start to enjoy the whole process of drawing. I know this can be a bit hard and it's a whole process. It took me quite some time to achieve this as well and to understand how could I do it. And that's why I'm doing this video, to help you out so you don't have to suffer for as long as I did. So here are a few tips to start enjoying the whole process of drawing. First thing is doing some drawing challenges. This can be done through prompts, for example, or through online challenges that are out there. If you go on social media, you'll notice that there are a lot of drawing challenges going around, especially Draw This In Your Style. It's one that really stays. A lot of people keep doing this one. So the artist will create an illustration, will draw something, and then you just need to recreate that drawing but in your own style. And I think it's a really fun challenge. I love doing those. There's so much stuff around there. Month specific challenges, for example, we have mermaid during the month of May, where we just draw mermaids for a whole month. During the month of October, you also have Inktober, for example. That's another thing that happens every year. I think that challenges are a very good way to start enjoying your art. Another thing that you can use is drawing prompts. If you Google it, you'll find lots of lists of prompts. I do have a video with some prompts to drawing your characters. I also have some free packs on Gumroad. If you want to try something, you are given a word and you draw something related to that. So let's say that the word is mushroom. You can open your sketchbook and draw a mushroom. That's it. You can go look for some pictures. You can just draw a simple mushroom. Or if you want, you can take a step further. You can create a character based on the word. So if the word is mushrooms, why not create a mushroom army or a mushroom princess? I don't know, there's so many possibilities. These kind of challenges can be really fun, and that will help you start enjoying your art more often, because you start forgetting about how good your art should be at the end, and you start focusing more on the fun of the whole process. And of course, maybe at the end you won't have the best results or the results you wish you had, but you still enjoyed the whole thing, you learn with it, and also you're doing this for yourself. And one thing you need to accept is that when you do something new, you probably won't be very good at it. That's the truth, and that's fine. But have fun with it. Have fun with that whole process. And this brings us to the next one, which is also on this realm of trying new things, and it is trying different mediums. Maybe you draw digitally. Why not step from that comfort zone that you have, and try out drawing with markers, for example, or trying those watercolors you bought so many years ago but then you never got to them. If you follow me here on YouTube or on Instagram, you know that I mostly draw digitally. I feel that my digital art is much better than my traditional art, and for a long time I wasn't comfortable sharing my traditional drawings. But at some point I thought, well, what the heck, I'm not good at those, but if I do it more often, I'll probably get better. And what I need is to see this as something fun. So I finally got some markers and I draw on a sketchbook with those from time to time. And yes, they're still not as good as my digital art. Still, it's something I really have fun with. I like the whole process. Also, one thing I want to point out here is that you don't really need to have super good materials here. For example, the watercolors I use, I had them for a long time, and they're just those kind of watercolors that you buy at the supermarket for kids. And well, they're not super good, but I'm also not looking to making very good quality drawings with this. I just want to have some fun and experiment with them a little bit. So sometimes I pick them up and draw something with them. I'm not good at it. I really suck at it, but it's fun and I'm trying something new. So I think that the best thing you can do when trying new thing is really having zero expectation. Assume that you're going to suck at it and then you're going to start to have much more fun, and at the end you might actually realize that you are better at it than you thought. Now my next tip is, and I do talk about this one quite a lot, start to consuming the things that you like. Drawing is much more than producing art. It's also about what you consume and what you see, because those things will feed your imagination, they will give you inspiration, and they will motivate you into drawing more and more. So read art books from artists that you like, follow those artists in social media, watch their art, see how they do things, read books and graphic novels from authors that you like as well, play games that you like, board games, anything that you are consuming is inspiring you. So don't overlook these things. One of my favorite games are the Dark Souls series and Bloodborne, and every year I will do some fan art of it. I'll think about Dark Souls and how much I love it, or I decide to go play it again for a bit and I fall in love with the games all over again and I feel like doing some fan art. So almost every year I will be posting some Dark Souls or some Bloodborne fan art, which is also a little bit weird at times, at least I feel like it is, because I always post really cute stuff. My characters are always going towards the cute side, and both Dark Souls and Bloodborne is a very dark environment, but I always have so much fun, and in the times that I want to draw this is always the times when I don't really feel as motivated about art, or I don't have ideas. So do consume the things that you like, be it it's TV shows, books, games, board games, whatever it is, be sure to do those things from time to time. And now my next tip for you to start enjoying a little bit more the process of drawing is having a journal or a sketchbook. Sometimes we get some new drawing ideas at the most unexpected times and places. And it's really good to have, even if it's something really small as a notebook, something that you can write on. You don't even need to draw. My sketchbooks are a mess of drawings, sketches of things that I will draw, doodles that I'm just doing aimlessly sometimes, and lots of notes. I have, maybe sometimes I have more writing than drawings on my small sketchbooks, because sometimes I have ideas but I don't have the time to work on them right now, so I will write them down so I can go to those later on. So always write everything down, and you, when you have that downtime where you don't have any project going on, you just don't have anything but you want to draw something, you pick one that feels more interesting for you and work on that. And finally, and this one is really 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 important, it is do what you love. I know that we live in an era of social media, numbers, we are always worried about the numbers and that's what matters, but truth is, it isn't. What matters is doing what you love. Let's say that suddenly you've gotten viral, a piece of work that you did really well, you got tons of new followers and you are really happy about that, so you decide to do that thing again and again and again because it worked. But maybe that's not what you like to do. And that can be a little bit frustrating, because sooner or later you are not going to enjoy drawing as much because you're not doing the things that you like. So don't think about numbers as much. You don't need to be following all those trends all the time. It's really tiring and it's not worth it most of the times. You're the one who's in charge, so do the things that you like and focus on those. That's the most important thing for you to enjoy the whole process. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, remember to like and subscribe for more, and remember, keep on drawing.